What's up guys, Sal here. So a couple of years ago, Samsung surprised everyone when they announced a strategic partnership with AMD that allowed Samsung use AMD's graphics technologies in their smartphone. We recently saw AMD CEO Dr. Lisa Su confirm that the next Samsung Exynos chipset will feature AMD's RDNA 2 graphics, which means the Galaxy S22 will be the first handset to debut AMD graphics in smartphones. We also saw benchmark leaks of this AMD GPU, and the scores show the chip performing much better than the Apple's A14 Bionic on the iPhone 12 lineup, at least when taking frame rates into account. So people thought that these cores are enough to beat the upcoming A15 Bionic on the iPhone 13 as well, thereby Samsung and AMD will take the crown as far as the graphics are concerned. But turns out that may not happen. According to a new benchmark leak, the A15 Bionic beats all of its competitors at least in one of the GPU benchmark tests. The A15 GPU will have a 6-core configuration like its predecessor, but a Manhattan 3.1 benchmark run using GFX Bench reveals that it overwhelms the competition by achieving an average frame rate of 198 frames per second for the first round. This is a little more than what Samsung and AMD achieved in the same test. But the problem with Apple is that they focus too much on the peak performance and not on the sustained performance. So just like previous years, after the first round, the GPU throttles and the scores of the A15 nosedive in the second round, where the average frame rate achieved is 140 to 150 frames per second. According to the available information we have, AMD has the same issue. The peak performance is great, but it's a steep drop thereafter. But when it comes to sustained performance, Qualcomm's chipsets are better than the rest. They do a better job of not throttling the chip for a longer period of time. But in any case, these are really impressive numbers for Apple, and fortunately, we are only a few days away from the iPhone 13 launch, so we'll see if these numbers translate into an actual product. With that said, here's some rumor about the Galaxy S22 and AMD chipset that you should definitely take with a heavy dose of salt. According to the South Korean forum The Client, the US market will get Snapdragon 898 equipped Galaxy S22 except for one carrier. Verizon has requested the Exynos 2200 powered Galaxy S22 models from Samsung, and the two companies are now negotiating. Honestly, this sounds a total BS. Samsung is not gonna sell two chipsets in one market, so if you ask me, the US market should only get the Snapdragon variant of the Galaxy S22. The same source also said that some Asian markets, including India, will likely get the Snapdragon variant instead of the usual Exynos. This could be possible because Samsung is having some yield issues with the AMD GPU on the Exynos 2200, so Samsung is finding it hard to produce a chipset in tens of millions for the global market. So it's totally possible India might get the Snapdragon variant this time, but like I've said, there are too many guesses in this report, so I would suggest you take this with a grain of salt as well. Anyway, do consider subscribing for all the latest tech news, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.